My research program has several different arms of it. Social support is a primary area that I do research in. I have studied since my graduate school days the support that children and adolescents perceive in their lives from various sources. Support that they get from their parents, from their teachers, their classmates, their friends, and how does that support relate to various outcomes for them, their academic outcomes as well as their social emotional outcomes. Leading from that social support research, Michelle Demery and I, another faculty member here in the program, we started looking at other outcomes that are related to social support, led us in the direction of bullying and school violence, and we've continued to do a lot of work in that area. Another area that I do some research in came out of my days. I was a practicing school psychologist for 2 years in Iowa, and one of the questions that I had as a practitioner was about how we were assessing written expression. And that one of the first research studies that I did when I came to NIU was on that topic. I collected data from area schools and looked at how we collect writing samples from students and how we score those samples in the most reliable and valid way. So that's another area that I continue to do work in. And that led to some research on the assessment of reading, and in particular curriculum-based measurement in reading. And I have a number of students using that measurement tool to answer a variety of interesting questions. A really important area of research that two of my students are doing have to do with really equity in terms of assessment and reading skills. So these students are working on reading curriculum-based measurement and looking at how we can better ensure that students are getting equitable services and that the services, interventions, the curriculum and instruction that we provide to them in schools is serving all students equally and serving allowing all students to be successful. So one student is looking at the achievement gap, looking at differences among different racial and ethnic minority students, as well as students who have lower socioeconomic status, and using curriculum-based measurement tools to be able to identify that gap just as early as it begins within the schools so that we can intervene. Rather than using high-stakes tests that happen typically only once a year, being able to use a tool that we can use 3 times a year allows us to identify that gap early and intervene so that the gap doesn't grow. The other student is looking at students who are learning English and looking at really what's the best way that we can assess whether we use English or Spanish. Primarily these are Spanish-speaking students, whether we should use the assessments in English or in Spanish, and at what point we use either one of those. So he's looking at really the ratio of instruction that's delivered in English or Spanish, and that the assessment at this point, his findings are that what other people have found as well, that the assessment that should be used really should match the primary language of instruction. But he's looking at that for his dissertation really quite carefully and with some sophisticated statistical techniques, and really excited about important implications that research could have for students who are learning English in our schools. Since starting at NIU, I've really taught the same graduate level courses in our program. I've taught the practicum sequence. So over the years, I've taught some first year practicum. Mostly, however, I've had the second year practicum course. The second year practicum course, we do a lot really around the topics that are important to practice in the schools. Students are in the schools a full day a week. During their second year, they're able to really engage in assessment, consultation, intervention, and all of the activities of a school psychologist. What's really been fun for me is that recently I've been able to start teaching one of our advanced practicum courses. And for the doctoral students in our advanced practicum, one semester we're in the Psychological Services Center. The Psychological Services Center, or the PSC, is connected to our building. It's part of our building. It's a very nice clinic setting. And our students pair up, the fourth year students and the third year students pair up and see clients together, with the more advanced student serving as a direct supervisor to the less advanced student who's actually seeing the client, working with the families, doing assessment, doing intervention, consulting with the schools. it's really quite nice for our students to be able to not only get the school-based experience, but also get the clinic-based experience. And that's very important for our doctoral students because they, all of them have their sights set on getting licensed as a licensed psychologist. In the state of Illinois, it's licensed clinical psychologist is their title. And to be able to do that, having that experience in a clinic is really valuable.